Yes, we'll be performing a relatively new concerto for flute by formerly Dallas-based composer Frank Ticelli. He's now on the faculty at University of Southern California, Thornton School of Music. Was born in Louisiana, but for all practical purposes, he grew up here, musically and otherwise, in Dallas. This piece was written in a response to a consortium, which was organized by a gentleman by the name of Peter Warshaw. There are a lot of things that, in a way, about this piece that are almost make it too lengthy to talk about right at the moment, but it's a really wonderful, beautiful, exciting piece. We have an extraordinary soloist, Marianne Gadigian, now on the faculty of the University of Texas in Austin, my colleague there. But she just plays this piece so beautifully, she does everything. But I think, especially this piece, our audience is going to be thrilled by her performance. And we will talk a lot more about some of the ins and outs of this really special piece, but I know that our audience. It'll be a very meaningful thing, so I hope that you'll join us for that, of course. Adam Schoenberg, whose music we have performed last season, his picture studies, but he has emerged as one of America's most important young musical voices. And this is his first, I think, big orchestral piece, Finding Rothko, and it has just now become available for wind ensembles to play. So I think this may be, in November, the second performance ever of the wind ensemble version of this, transcribed beautifully by Lance Semple, who's on the faculty of the University of Minnesota now. But Finding Rothko is a piece that explores the art of Mark Rothko. Some of you have been perhaps to the Rothko Chapel in Houston, and if you look at Rothko's art, sometimes it is difficult to put an explanation to it because it's this wonderful blending of color. And that's what this piece explores, is how color can emerge and change literally with no line and no demarcation point, sometimes from one edge of the painting to the other edge of the painting, or with solid blocks of color that seem to somehow merge and fuse. So it's a really exciting piece, and I think it works beautifully in the wind ensemble medium. We are doing a year-long, in a way, retrospective of some of the works of David Maslanka, some of them that we have not performed before. On our first concert, we were doing the Fifth Symphony. On the last concert of the year, we were doing his 10th Symphony, the one that was unfinished at the time of his death this past year. But this is a piece that he wrote for a band called Traveler, which is a combination fanfare, then with a quiet, also almost like a march, but then at the end, a beautiful chorale section, which is so evocative. I think it's fantastic music, and it's one of those pieces that the instant you hear it, if you know David Maslanka's music, it just sounds like David Maslanka. It's almost hard to describe why that is, but it's very exciting, and I know our audience is going to really enjoy it. Sometimes people will make suggestions to me, and I will think, well, you know, that piece would be nice to include on a concert, but there's really no way to wrap that up and sort of make it work. But one of our subscribers suggested that we should do Capriccio Italian, wondered if there was a band arrangement of it because it was one of her favorite pieces, and actually it fits beautifully to close this concert. So believe it or not, we do listen to our subscribers and those people who make great suggestions all the time. So this is a listener request. So if you have those, please contact us. But it's a great one because Capriccio Italian, of course, by the great Russian composer Tchaikovsky, but somehow he's able to capture the Italian spirit and flair like very few other people did.